Om Shri Sai Ram. For my humble pranams at the lotus feet of my Lord Bhagwan Sathya Sai Baba. I offer koti koti pranams to the Lord within you all and me also, the divinity that lives in all of us. I offer my pranams to the Sathya Sai Trust members and all the senior Sai devotees and of the organization. Brother, non-human energies. This was conducted in last September, and the 46 samples study was made. Pre and post energies of the Seva Dal were taken, and what is the difference between the pre and post energy? What is their stress levels? And how it has affected was being diagnosed here. I am just putting up certain things. This is a Swami's quotes, that Paropkarartham Idharm Shariram. Next. Why we should do seva? To purify the mind, to remove contamination. Purity leads to unity, to reach to divinity through purity and unity. Next. Sadhana also. A small sadhana was offered in between the seva, and mainly what sadhana we have offered, we will show you also that. Sadhana is a transformation that leads to fulfillment. Sadhana is a spiritual practice that is done to tune ourselves with the Almighty. Next. Why we should do sadhana? To drive the inner joy, to remove the selfless desire, sealing on desire and dedication to serve others. Next. This is the cycle which I have shown, that pure heart will lead to more seva, refined seva, seva will lead to purified mind, and again purified mind lead to sadhana. So this is a wonderful cycle that one can enjoy by doing sadhana and seva. Next. This is where the study actually started. This study is based upon the EPI method, that is electrophotonic imaging. You might have heard about the Kirlian photography, and what the camera which I tried here in Prasanthi Nilayam is 7 generation ahead of Kirlian photography. This is the latest one. This is known as BioWell camera, and this BioWell is being designed by the Konstantin Kartoko. It's a Russian camera with which I have tried. And the purpose of this was to observe and record the level of energy influence on human due to seva and sadhana. The venue was Prasanthi Nilayam. A sample of 46 people, sevadal male and female with different age group, different seva points, including group leaders, were done. And pre and post scan for all the samples were done. The parameters for the assessment was energy field, chakras and stress level. Next. The objective was to find out the EPI electrophotonic imaging in details, to observe the record of level energy influence on human, to assess the change in the energy levels, assessment of physical, physiological and emotional and spiritual bioenergy fields during seva activities, and also to see the seva and sadhana effect on the chakras. Next. This was some of the photographs which we took while conducting the scan. Next. Here is the graphical presentation of the outcome of our research. These 46 samples were taken. And if you see these 46 samples, the age group wise, there were, if you see, the male were 10 and female were 3 in the age group of 20 to 40. For 41 to 50, there were male 5 and female 5. And in 51 and above was male 12 and 10 females. The total study was of 46. These are all random sampling. We have taken the sevadal as they came to us. There was no specific requirement. They are of a different age group, different work they are doing, and they have been allotted different seva also at the different seva points. Next. This was the small sadhana which we have suggested them, the namasmarana or bhajan singing in between the seva or while doing the seva. The most important sadhana which we gave was the prem sadhana, speaking with love. There were some instructions from our side to use the minimum mobiles while they were in Prasanthi Nilayam, and do not fight with anybody, or do not have an anger while doing the seva. Next. This is the first result which we, in the case studies which we are presenting. This is a female of 36 year age. She was doing a seva in the super hospital. The seva sadhana given was help ever, hurt never, and 21 Sayatri mantras were given. And if you see the stress level, this is the first on the left hand side, that orange is the stress level. Initial stress level was very high. It was, you know, in fact more than the anxiety level for her. And if you see the dark blackish graph, you will see that it has dropped down to normal almost. And here also, in the second studies, if you see this aura also, if you see the energy levels in the jewels has also increased, and it is more uniform. If you see the pre scan and the post scan in the aura, you will see there is a tremendous difference. There is a linearity, there is very clear color pictures which we can easily recognize. Here also the stress level was reduced. In this case, you will find that this chakra, which has to be in the linear line, initially if you see the blank ones were the previous scan, and now if you see these are almost in the linear way. This is he was a district president, and at the age of 63, we took his scan, and this is the aura which we got. There also the stress level was reduced. Let's go to the graphical presentation and conclusions now. The very good results were more than 20% change in the three parameters, that is energy. And if you see that it is very good for more than 36.9, good, that is 10 to 20, was 34.7, stable was for say about 10.8, and it was negative for 17.3. So there were some negative results also which we obtained. I will elaborate to you when I go further. Next. If you see the three parameters, this is the energy field, chakra and stress level. These are the three fields where we scan. And if you see the male and female, the male chakra energies were around 75% better, whereas in energy field the improvement is for female is 87%. In chakra they were almost equal, but in stress level the female have shown more improvement than the male in the stress level in the post energy scan. Next. This is regarding the group leaders. In this group leader, if you see that the changes which we have seen in the seva dal is less than what we see here in the group leaders. You will see that the energy field is also just improved to 57%, chakra is almost same, but in female it is very weak, and stress level there is a big improvement up to 66%. Next. What we observed that there is a big improvement in the energy levels, and this negative impact which we got was mainly because of some emotional shocks that has come to these sevadals. We came to know that there was some death in the family of a sevadal whom we were scanning. There was one sevadal whose daughter was very sick while in the seva. So he was having tremendous pressure on that also. So this has reflected in the scan also, pre and post op post scan when we did the same scans for these people. And most importantly, what we saw that the entire graph has lowered down to some extent is because of the group leaders. Because when you get some authority, your Anahat chakra, that is the Prema chakra, it gets shrinked. And the energy released by this Anahat chakra is reduced because of the ego or the Ahankara which they develop. And that is why we see the difference in the energy levels. And this has been clearly seen here. When I come to the conclusions, I have said that this is a Prem Sadhana, that is speaking with love with everyone is a big Sadhana, and every group leader should be given this Sadhana before coming to Seva, or even the orientation camp should be taken for the group leaders so that they can have this better picture of energies for themselves also. I have submitted this as my thesis to the International Open University for Alternative Medicine, and I got the PhD for this research. This is a wonderful research, and this is associated with the United Nations. And this research was acceptable. In fact, this is the only research we have on Seva and Sadhana in the entire world. Nobody has done this type of research so far, which we have presented. I will come to the next research. I thank Nimish sir and Ramesh Savan sir also, Satputeji, our batch in charge, Mukesh Patel sir, and Krishna Madappa, who has also helped me. He is a president of the International Spirituality and Science Institute. I will come to the second. Regarding this second presentation, I just want to tell you that this was conducted exactly 1 year back when I was thinking of doing this research. I thought that I should do some research on the space energy also. What we saw, this was a human energy form, change in the human energies. Now we did the research on the space energy. This was the antenna which was used here in Prasanthi. In fact, it was there when you all sang and chanted Rudram last year. I was sitting there with my antenna and also the computer, and I got the readings there. And it is developed now in the form of a presentation. Let's see what has happened. I offer my humble pranams to the Bhagwan. Next. Science of Rudram. Next. This is where the picture where we all were sitting and chanting Rudram last year. Next. This is the most important Trambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam. Next. What we got from the text is that Rigveda has said that Lord Shiva is a father of microbes, and all atomic particles is this creation. And Atharva Veda deals with the atomic fusion of the elements, and it is a dance of subatomic particles. While Yajurveda says that Sri Rudram is the perfect set of vibration which generates energy. And I wanted to establish what type of energy it generates. Next. Indrudram is a very powerful mantra. It is in science it is said that the microbes are unfolded in Sri is Namakam, and science of Parmanu unfolded in Sri Rudram is Chamakam. Everything in the earth is an energy and everything is vibrating. So I wanted to establish the relationship of vibrations with Rudram. Next. The location was Sathya Sai Prasanthi Nilayam again. It was conducted on the first International Veda Conference, 21st and 22nd. The hour of duration was 5:58 in the morning to 10:28, that is 30 minutes. To measure the spital response of Rudram chanting, over 10,000 sadhakas. Next. I have used this antenna. This is a titanium sensor. I have kept it here just to see every one of you. This is a Sputnik antenna which I have kept, and this gives the entire vibrations of the space. It is the density of the electrophotonic imaging. As the increase at the density increases of the electrons and electrophotons, then we can find out how much it has increased. There were three parameters which were assessed, was area, intensity and energy. I was sitting here, you can see in that picture. Next. These are the graphs which I got on my computers. It is like an ECG graphs. These are all ECG graphs. And when I calculated the entire things, I have made 11 folders. While we all were chanting, I made 11 folders at Namakam, Chamakam, Om Shanti. Various places I have made a folder. I wanted to know which of these are showing more energies. That is why, for my practical research purposes, I have done this. Next. This is the area. If you see the area wise also, the intensity, area represents the emotional response to the molecule in the assembly hall during the actual chanting. Here we observe a steady increase in the chart values from start to finish of the chant. It means that the energy has increased in the area wise also. If this is calculated, I can tell you that this energy could be calculated, and if I put the Sputnik even 10 kilometers away from Puttaparthi, the same energy I could have detected there, because it has reached to that level. Next. This is the intensity. If you see the intensity, these are 11 folders. At all the 11 folders, you will find that this energy is increasing. Intensity represents the level of photon per count per each of the respective intent point during the chants, and also shows a steady increase in the values. You will see that these values are increasing. These are all in joules. Next. Energy. This is a wonderful observation which I got. When we do the calibration, because once we want to start the experiment, we do the calibration. And calibration is done to that atmosphere so that we get 1 joule as an initial level. And once that 1 joule is achieved, immediately we start the experiment. But in Prasanthi and in Sai Kulvantol, when I did the calibration and just I brought at 1 joule, within a second it has gone to 3. It means that the energy in Prasanthi was 3 times more than the normal anywhere energy in the other places. And even when I forwarded this data to Americans, they have given me a certificate, and they said that this is the highest energy we have ever recorded at any place. Energy represents the thermodynamic reserves at an assembly hall during the phase of instrument. These values are in joules and show that steady increase. You will see that even it has gone from 330 to 359, and there is a steady increase. It means that not only this energy, basic energy, was very high, but it was increasing very, very rapidly. This American scientist, when I discussed with them and I forwarded this data to them by email, they said that this is the most rich data we have. Very, very rich data they have. And that is why they have given us a certificate on this. Let's go to the last one. Next. This is known as standard deviation. This standard deviation is a statistical distribution of the collective response or influence in the assembly hall. The closer the value are the zero, the higher the coherence. This is very important. And exactly the same thing has been observed here. When we were all chanting Rudram, but the moment we came to Om Shanti Shanti Shanti, you will see that we are almost at the zero level. See, this is 56.67. And that too from 110. So it is so important that we were at the all same conscious level. Our conscious energy of everyone was at the lowest. So we were all in coherence with each other. And that is the exact thing which we should achieve when we chant. So this is the most important observation which I found. Next. This is the certificate which we got, and they also say that energy will be begun with and higher than the normal in the relation to human environment conditioning, and it can be attributed to the continuum of the inactions. It means that what they have said, that there is regularly some chanting, Veda chanting is going on in this place, and that is why the initial energy itself is very high, and that has gone up more than what it was. So this was the most successful experiment which I did, and I think all of you can take this to all your colleagues and even the sadhakas in your samitis and tell them that chanting of Rudra is so important that it can increase the energy levels anywhere. And also tell everyone that by doing the seva they can increase their energy levels, because this is the first documented thing on both in space energy as well as from the view of human energies that we conducted at Prasanthi Nilayam. I thank you all. I thank my All India President Ramesh Sawant sir and everyone, those who have given me the opportunity to do this, and look forward to do more work on this. Thank you so much. Sai Ram.